work as a delegate in the United Nations promoting these universal laws. And you are all here today. The underlying theme is because you want peace. So even in so that's why you're here. But even in ancient times, there was a wise man. His name was Ben Zoma, Jewish sage, who said, Ben Zoma said, "Who is wise? One who learns from every single person." This is a quote. Who is brave? One who subdues his negative inclination, meaning he controls it. Who is rich? One who appreciates what he has, because he can have a million things and still never be happy. Who is honored? One who gives honor to someone else. Jewish sages explain that the wonders of God's creation is that although no two human faces are the same, so too are no two human minds. They're not identical. No two people think alike, no two people look alike. We are all different, since differences are an inherent dimension of God's creation. Means God created us all different. He created us all thinking differently. We don't look alike, we don't think alike. Even two people growing up in the same education, the same environment, don't think alike. How much more so when we come from different cultural and economic and social backgrounds. So but nonetheless, as Ben Zoma says, who is wise? One who can learn from every single person. Every single one of us has something to share, and we can learn from each other. There is something in every single one of us. Building a connection is the key goal in the Rebbe's, Rabbi Menachem and Schneerson's proposed. And he talked about the seven universal laws as a bridge for non-Jews to come together as one. And he also spoke about how these laws, this ancient wisdom, should be shared by all people. The Torah is universal, because God doesn't give a set of rules for one people and he lets everyone else stumble in the dark. He has rules and guidelines and guides every single person. He doesn't just let anyone. So ultimately, the difference is, you know, there are many different representatives and here right now. And what we need to do is publicly come together as one and to come together with the universal Noahide laws. And first of all, commit to honoring the Creator and ultimately His creations. His creations contain right here and right now. The United Nations is made up of 193 countries, as we said before, counting. To truly unite, we need to bring in the godly power, which is the one that created everyone and creates everyone. And we can learn from each other's cultures, and now we can learn from each other's cultures. We should celebrate each other's cultures. We should actually find the thread, because ultimately, this God created people don't look alike, and it's beautiful to see differences of cultures, differences of people coming together as one. When we come together as one, that reflects the oneness of God. Because before God created the world, he was only God. He had unity. He created diversity. In other words, tall people, short people, intellectual people, more emotional people. You know, all sorts of men, women, everyone. There's no two people think alike. Absolutely. You cannot find two people thinking alike. He created a collage of people. So when we all come together as one, not to be one, men don't have to be women. Women don't have to be men to prove themselves. It's coming together and finding the commonality, the thread that unites us. Then we ultimately bring about peace and love for everyone. As next week, we know is Hanukkah. Hanukkah is a time when we light the menorah, which signifies a triumph over freedom, light, and universal, which are all our universal values. Now, the origin of the menorah was sent from the moment when a few people confronted a huge, well-trained army, like a superpower like we have. Despite our numbers, there was few amongst many. They were weak against the strong, etc., etc. They were ultimately triumphant, and they brought about freedom. This also is a symbol of freedom, which menorah, which light, which is a yearning for people to exercise their religious freedom without external impositions. And finally, the menorah also incorporates the notion that every day we have to increase in light. As you know, the first day we light one light, the second day two, and so on. That we cannot be satisfied with our achievements of yesterday. Every day we have to focus on increasing in goodness and kindness, and adding light, increasing in reaching out and understanding fellows and people from other cultures, other backgrounds. Not to be satisfied, okay, I made friends with one person, that's it. Every day we have to add light, and a candle, the interesting thing about a candle is, a candle, when you light another candle, you lose nothing from yourself. It just creates a ripple effect. Like I gave this fellow a second card, I said, spread the light. The idea is, share it. And this is like the butterfly that flaps its wings, will have a ripple effect. And before you know it, we're in a global village, where we're interconnected, whether we like it or not. So we have to utilize the connection for Hashem to bring us together, not to divide, to find the half full, the glass half full, to appreciate who is rich, one who appreciates what he has. Thank God for whatever you have. Don't wake up and show gratitude. Wake up and appreciate that you're healthy. You know, when it comes to physical, look down, meaning look down someone who has less than you and appreciate. When it comes to someone more spiritual, look up. Look at someone who is greater than you and emulate him and try to strive to be better. The idea is, let's focus on the good and the positive in each and every one of us. Let's find the common thread that unites us all as one. For we really are one. There's no two people, even though we don't look like, but yet feel the pain the same way, we bleed the same way, we appreciate a good joke, which I would tell you I started a good joke, but now is when it's in a synagogue, you come to the UN, I'll tell you a few jokes. I'll end off with a joke, actually. And I told this to one, I'm not going to say it to one of the delegates, he was, we're not going to end off with a joke, but I'll just tell you a joke. It was a rabbi and a priest walking down Fifth Avenue. And as you know, I wear a black fedora. And you know, the priestess, the rabbi, you know, for the sake of unity, I'm going to buy one of those black hats. So you go into Saks Fifth Avenue, and they ask him, how much is the hat? $1,500. Wow, that's a lot of money. Okay. For the sake of unity, you put down $1,500. And after 5 minutes, they're walking, the rabbi talking about peace and about unity. After 5 minutes, a pigeon comes and does its job on the priest's new hat. And the priest right away says, God damn it. And the rabbi says, thank God. So the priest turns to the rabbi, what do you mean, thank God? Here I am trying to create unity. I even brought a black hat. I'm walking nicely. We're talking about bringing unity. And you say, thank God? He says, thank God cows don't fly. So you always have to look at the positive side of things. That this, you know, but let me, you know, my fellow brothers and sisters, let me end off on a serious note, reflecting, you know, something positive. You know, we read in Psalms, it says, praise the Lord, you, all nations, extol him, all your people, for his kindness was mighty over us. His truth of the Lord is everlasting. Praise the Lord. And I'll say it in Hebrew, Hodu Adonai ki tov ki elohim chazo, which means Hodu means blessing. And when we celebrate each other's divinely given differences and reflecting the ethics of the seven universal Noahic laws, code, we will usher in ultimately the great day when it says, as Isaiah puts it so profoundly, there will come a time when we will take swords, instruments of war, and transform them into plowshares, instruments to provide man's food. And may we see that happen today. Amen. Thank you. I'll take any questions if you want, if anyone wants to ask any questions.